wa kwanza kusaini hii dokumenti yetu ambaye ni ya manufaa kwa hawa. From there, Your Excellency, we had invited some party leaders who are with us, and we are going straight to invite our Honorable Isaac Ruto, representing Chama cha Mashinani. Tumkaribishe tafadhali. From South Rift, Chama cha Mashinani, Isaac Ruto, karibu mheshimiwa. Karibu, 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 karibu. Aya. All your, yeah, your names are there. And you'll be followed by the Honorable Wafula Wamunyinyi. Anza kukuja. Thank you, Governor Isaac. Asante. Well done. Wamunyinyi. Karibu. Karibu sana. And next, from there, followed by my former classmate Alfred Mutua. My former classmate, we were in with him in Dagoretti High School. Karibu. Thank you very much, Alfred Mutua. Thank you very much. Followed by Gideon Moi. Followed by Wetangura, Moses Wetangura. Thank you, Gidi. Asante. Wetangura, followed by Ari Hassan Joho from Mombasa. Karibu. Karibu Joho. Aya, asante sana. Next is our governor, Charity Ngiru. And after that, I will invite Farah Marim, representing Wiper Party. Wiper Party is representing Kalonzo Musyoka, who has sent his apologies. He's out of the country. He called me last evening. Thank you very much.
Plus
Before I invite Musare Mudavadi, I want to invite Francis Atuori. Francis Atuori. Say away to Francis Atuori. After that, it's not there. After that, I would like to take this opportunity now to invite Honorable Musaria Mudavadi.
Moja nchi yangu na ilina Tunapenda amani upendo na haki Tunatoka kwa giza tuashi kwa mwanga Wana muziki
Nishuda
Walimu wote
Nishuda
Madakitai
Thank you very much
Na wachimba migodi
Thank you very much Musaria Mudavadi And now I want to take this opportunity On behalf of the Council of Governors I invite Governor Oparanya
Nishuda
On behalf of all the governors. Karibu, karibu, governor. Tumpigie makofi, tumpigie makofi. Asante, all our governors are represented by Wycliffe Oparanya. Asante. Now, Your Excellency and Right Honorable Prime Minister, before we go to the next step, the next level, we want to invite you now into some videos and you come back. And now it will be your part to endorse the document and give your signature. Thank you very much, and I promise you that we are going to take under 1 hour. Thank you very much. Thank you. Junet, you can take the next part of the program.
Your Excellency, the President of the Republic of Kenya, the Prime Minister, the Right Honorable Raila Amolo Odinga, Your Excellency, my duty is just to tell the gathering the way forward and what you have planned going forward. And I think we have planned very well. The Secretariat is up and running. We have timelines and schedules that we have prepared. And I think with the help of the I don't know whether it's on the board, we have told them we have dates that we are collecting signatures from today for 1 week until the end of this month. Then we will take it to IBC, God willing, after we verified at the secretariat level. Then we will, the IBC, we expect them to take the shortest time period to look at the signatures because they have already approved the format that we wrote to them and they approved the format that we intend to use to collect the signatures. And after that, we will take it to the county assemblies, and we have over 30 governors present here. That's an indication that the document is as good as done. They have, by coming here, is a sign of endorsement. Then after that, we are going to take it to Parliament, and Parliament, the leadership is here. The two speakers are here. That is also as good as done. Then from there, we are going to take it to the people of Kenya, to make a decision on it. Your Excellency, we are going to go out there and follow the COVID protocols. We are going to do our meetings in town halls with not attendance not more than 100 people until this COVID is maybe gone. But life will continue, Your Excellency, because you will see, as much as people have serious problems with COVID, but life must move on, even in countries in Africa where they have elected presidents. In Tanzania, they have elected president when corona is still there. In Guinea-Bissau, in Equatorial Guinea, even Trump was defeated when we still have corona. So we'll move on, Your Excellency, but we will make sure, we promise you that as a secretariat, we will abide by the rules of the Minister of Health under the corona protocols. With those few remarks, Your Excellency, I also want to take this opportunity to introduce the leadership of Parliament who are here. It's very important. Some of them played critical roles in developing this agenda that we are today launching. We have my leader here, the minority leader in the National Assembly. Please, you can wave. We also have the majority leader in the Senate, Honorable Bogisio, Senator Bogisio. We have my counterpart, the whip of the majority, Honorable Wangwe. We have the whip of the minority in the Senate, Senator Mutula Jr. We also have the chairman of the Justice and Legal Affairs Committee, Honorable Muturi Kigano. We also have our father and chairman of Nairobi, Honorable Kamanda. I'm just giving him special recognition because of the role I know he plays when we come to Nairobi for us who are coming from the villages. So, Your Excellency, lastly, I want to introduce also the chair lady of KEWOPA, the Kenya Women Parliamentary Association, Honorable Wamushomba. I'm also an ex-official member of that group, as KEWOPA. We have also, I'm coming to it, is the majority, I know he's the majority leader. So, Your Excellency, we have also the majority leader of the National Assembly, our leader, Honorable Amos Kimunya. Your Excellency, we have also developed digital app that can help Kenyans to sign digital. For those who have advanced technologically, who can use, the app will be shown up here right now. You can go to www.bbi.org and you will follow the instructions that are written there. Then you sign and your signature and your ID and all your details will be captured in that format, and it will be used as part of the signatures. So this is the program we have for the secretariat. On 23rd November to 23rd December, we have moved now to the app. The app is www.bbisignatures.org. So if you log into that website, you will be able to sign like any other person who's signing physically, and your signature will be valid, and it will be used. So if you are in Nairobi, you can log into that website and you will be able to sign for the BBI. So, Your Excellency, with those few remarks, I don't want to take a lot of time. We are ready and raring to go. We are prepared and we will make sure that our agenda of uniting this country is achieved through the BBI. Thank you so much, Your Excellency. And now we will go to a short video clips. Then after that, you shall be invited, you and the Prime Minister, to sign, and I'm sure those two signatures will carry a lot of votes during the referendum. Thank you so much.
Komajira ni Donald Omondi Obuya. Kwa hii BBI, sisi kama watu wa jua kali, tumepewa miaka saba tukiendesha biashara, tukifanya biashara bila kutoza ushuru. Maisha sasa hizi ni kujijenga na kujenga uchumi ya nchi yetu.
I have a 4-year grace period to plan myself and repay my help. That's why I endorse BBI.
Ngaje wasaya, mtaimia tu vijana kujijenga na kujenga mita zetu. BBI iko mbele ama vipi?
Thank you. tutaendelea kulinda familia yangu vile BBI itatulinda zote. BBI oye, BBI ndani, BBI tick.
Mimi kama senior citizen wa Kenya, ningependa kuunga mkono BBI, BBI oye.
Nafurahia BBI itaimarisha biashara yangu. BBI oye.
Nafurahia BBI kukumbuka wazee kama sisi wa miaka 65 tena zaidi. Bima ya afya itakuwa bure kwangu na wengine wote. BBI oye. Oh yeah.
Aje, BBI itatupeleka mbele. Stage ya mwisho Kenya moja. BBI kabisa. Ni aje Gonda tuende ama namna gani?
Good morning Honorable Raila. My name is Natalie Zileha. I am happy that you have come. Good morning, Honorable Raila. My name is Natalie Zileha. I am happy that you have come.
Your Excellency, the little girl is inviting Honorable Raila Amolo Odinga to apex his signature. Sorry for that hiccup. So, nitamwalika mheshimiwa aliyekuwa waziri mkuu na kundradhi kwa hitilafu hizo. Tumwalika sasa aweze kutia sahihi yake. Tumkaribishe kwa makofi mheshimiwa aliyekuwa waziri mkuu mheshimiwa Raila Odinga. Nitaomba mheshimiwa Raila atasimama kidogo ili sasa nimwalike mheshimiwa Uhuru Kenyatta, rais wa jamhuri yetu ya Kenya na amiri jeshi mkuu kuweza kutia sahihi yake. Karibu sana mheshimiwa rais. Tumpongeze kwa makofi mheshimiwa rais anapotia sahihi. Na nitaomba sasa watasimama kando wote wawili kila moja upande wake mheshimiwa Raila. Nitaomba ukaribia kidogo tu mheshimiwa rais. Takaribia kidogo.
Kituma kuchapa kazi class na bidii. Tunapambana sana kuijenga jamii. Iwe ni jua kali hatujali. Kenya ni nyumbani na sihami.
Asante, asante sana. Asante. Shukran. Asante sana. Nafasi hii nitamwalika aliyekuwa waziri mkuu mheshimiwa Raila Amolo Odinga ili aweze kuzungumza nasi kwa kifupi. Karibu mheshimiwa.
Nobody can Your Excellency, the President of the Republic of Kenya, fellow leaders of the people of Kenya, na wananchi wote wa Kenya kwa jumla, hamjambo. Hamjambo tena. We are opening a new chapter of the book we started writing in March 2018. The chapters we have answered, we have covered, so far have been quite interesting and engaging. But it is about to get even more interesting with the chapter we open today of collecting signatures, and then the next three, going to the country assemblies, then to parliament, and then to a referendum. It's a great time to be in Kenya and to participate in the making of history. In these chapters, we are working on our hopes, not fears, in search of the unity and prosperity we all desire. By appending our signature today, after going through the bill, we are stamping a seal of approval of the process, the necessity, it all and final to the document. I appeal to the patriotic Kenyans to come out in record numbers and append their approval in a record time so that we move to the next chapter. I have worked with our people in the processes of change like this one for a long time, and I know for a fact that Kenyans are not slow learners when it comes to seizing the moment for change. I am confident that Kenyans will close this chapter in a record time. At all times, remember that we are doing it in the middle of a pandemic. Throughout this period and beyond, let us pay attention to the COVID-19 protocols. Wear masks, keep social distance, wash or sanitize our hands. Our coordinators across the country must understand that other than collecting signatures, they have a duty to protect the lives of our patriotic citizens who show up to append their signatures. And our coordinators must ensure our citizens know what they are signing. Fellow Kenyans, there is a land we can see, the promised land. We have trekked through the difficult days of hatred and division. We have gone through the wilderness of anger and marginalization. We can see the promised land ahead. But the promised land will never come to us. We have to go to it. That was and that remains the condition for getting to the promised land. We have to keep going. You've got to keep going, keep moving forward, never fearing what lies around the corner. Martin Luther King Jr. said, and I quote, he told us, "Cowardice asks the question, is it safe? Expediency asks the question, is it politic? Vanity asks the question, is it popular? But conscience asks the question, is it right? And there comes a time when we must take a position that is neither safe, nor politic, nor popular, but one must take it because it is right." Tumetoka mbali, mliona kule tulitoka. Kulikuwa Kasarani, na baadaye kukaja Uhuru Park. Kisha tukaja Harambee House. Alafu tukashikana mkono. Tukasema, yaliyopita si ndwele, tugange yaliyomo na yajayo. And we said this, we're not going to go back in this. It's a legacy we want to bequeath to the people of Kenya, to unite the people so that they can become one people. So that a name does not elicit anger, pain, or happiness only. So that each and every child born in our country, irrespective of their socioeconomic status, has equal opportunity to realize their God-given abilities. That all our people can live peacefully. They can access health care irrespective of their financial status. This is what we said that time after those lengthy deliberations with my brother. And there have been now prophets of doom. Oh, this constitution is creating an imperial presidency, recreating it. You're very intelligent and learned people. You will read through those lines and tell us where we are recreating an imperial presidency. I know, because we are victims of imperial presidency and we cannot recreate one. If you have a prime minister nominated by the president but appointed by parliament, and who can only be removed by parliament, how does that increase the powers of the presidency? It's actually reduced the power of presidency. And the prime minister is going to be sitting in the National Assembly and answering questions of members of parliament. And every week going there, prime minister's hour. How I enjoyed that interaction with members of parliament. And they also enjoyed coming to provoke me so that I could blunder. Then ministers are going to be sitting in the National Assembly. They will be asked questions and they have to answer. And if it is an emergency, it is called question by private notice. It has to be answered within 48 hours. And if the answer is not satisfactory, the speaker will say, I defer the question to next week. The Honorable Minister must go with the Honorable Member of Parliament to the scene and bring us a satisfactory answer. That makes the government much more accountable rather than inviting a minister to appear before a parliamentary committee where he's just harassed by members of parliament. This is something that is going to be something new in our view, and we think it's improving. Oh, you are eroding the independence of the judiciary. How? The executive is there, the legislature and the judiciary. You said the judiciary must be independent, but it must also be oversighted. Where do wananchi go to appeal or to register their complaints against the judiciary? An ombudsman. But how about if the ombudsman is appointed by the Chief Justice, who also is the president of the Supreme Court? And then the ombudsman is supposed to go and report to the Judicial Service Commission, but appointed by the Chief Justice. Of course, this fellow cannot oversight the Chief Justice. That's why it is said the president appoints the ombudsman, but ombudsman will be interviewed through a panel, and three names submitted to the president, who will pick one of them and send to parliament for vetting. Then finally appointed by the presidency. How does that erode the independence of judiciary? Many other things have been said about this. It is dividing the people of Kenya. It is not addressing the issues of the common man, Mama Mboga, the Juakali, the water wheelbarrows, and so on. Those are issues which are legislative, not constitutional matters. And each and every government will come with their policies. Those are not things you put in the constitution. So what we have picked out are issues which are completely essential to improve governance in our country. Oh, the electoral commission is going to be appointed by political parties. Everybody among you here who have been around since we introduced multi-party politics in this country will agree that the most transparent elections in our country were those of 2002, conducted by an electoral commission appointed through the IPPG process. The President Moi had already appointed 10 members. The opposition appointed 10, 3 for Kenya, 3 for Dasili, 3 DP, and 1 Kenya Social Congress. 10. So they were checking the other 10 who have been appointed by President Moi. And therefore it was fairly independent because they were kind of checking each other. If you go to Mexico, that is the thing. In many countries, that is the formula because the political parties are the actors. In this world, there's nobody who's neutral. Even if you give the Pope the ballot, the Pope will go into the ballot box there and will vote for somebody. So everybody, there's nobody who is neutral. I appoint an independent panel to appoint these people. Let them be independent. How? They will counter checking each other. And political parties will consult among each other. What we are talking about here is not only happening in Kenya. That's how it's done in many other countries in the world. New democracies. So there are things that have gone into this, a lot of thoughts have gone, very many brains have worked on this. Some of the best brains in this country have been working together with the committee of, with the steering committee. And this is the result. So we are starting a new journey today, and we invite each and every Kenyan to work with us. We are confident that if we come together as a people, nothing can stop us from realizing the Kenyan dream as coined by the founding fathers of our nation. So Reggae went in a recess because it was half time. Wachezaji wanarudi kwa kiwanja. Nobody can stop Reggae. Ndugu yangu, Rais Uhuru Kenyatta, karibu.
Asante. Asante sana jameni tuketi. Hamjambo wenzangu. Hamjambo tena. Asante sana. Kenya wenzangu, we are gathered here today for an exercise in citizenship, and we do so in fidelity with the tenets of our participatory democracy by representing and presenting the proposed changes to our constitution, as indeed we seek yours and every single Kenyan's support through a referendum. I believe that this is a proud moment for our democratic system of government, which holds that we are a nation of equal citizens, striving for the betterment of our families, our communities, and our nation as a whole. Fellow Kenyans, democracy is dynamic because people are dynamic. We change as individuals, our families grow, we encounter challenges, some that are unexpected, and others that are devastating, as well as some that create hope. And we embrace opportunities, many of which are transformative and uplifting. The reality of life demands constant change if we are to solve challenges and indeed be able to capitalize on our opportunities. Indeed, I strongly believe that the reason our founding fathers and mothers bequeathed us a democratic system was to offer us this dynamic ability to change with time, and to change as equal citizens of this beautiful land. The nation, fellow Kenyans, is a product of continuous evolution. It is a product made constantly and purposefully. And indeed, the tree of the nation is watered with a constant stream of ideas. Without this, a nation withers and dies. The only thing, indeed, as we all know, that is static and that does not change is that which is dead. And history, the world over, is a graveyard of empires and nations that died because they responded to the changing dynamics affecting them by digging in their heels and resisting change. Fellow Kenyans, as I said when I was delivering my State of the Nation address, a nation, any nation, is a work in progress. And that is why the idea of nation building was on the lips of our founding fathers and the leaders then of a young Kenya. And one of the greatest acts of nation building in our history, I believe, was the promulgation of the 2010 Constitution. This sacred document contains the democratic dreams of Kenya that demand great sacrifices from many Kenyans, known and unknown. As President and your fellow citizen, I want to take this opportunity to give thanks to the gallant Kenyans who argued, advocated for, and suffered so that our Constitution would come alive. For decades, many heroes and heroines woke up wishing us a better Kenya, a strengthening of our democracy and our governance. And in 2010, when my predecessor lifted the new Constitution high, all of us cheered and entered a new phase in the life of this great republic. But we knew then, as we know now, that no document is perfect and that time does not stand still. And that is the reason the framers of the Constitution gave us the ability to change it, but in a way that protects its core democratic character. The need for change of our Constitution has been with us for some time. It has been evident in the never-ending threat of post-election violence, in the growing feelings that its design lacks inclusivity, and that it promotes unfair and skewed representation and unfair distribution of national resources. So we need together to strengthen the 2010 Constitution. And I want to make it clear here that we're not talking about replacing a constitution. We're talking about amending a constitution, the first of many possible amendments that will come over a period of time as Kenyans change and evolve. And if we are to continue our decades-long journey in seeking to advance the well-being of all Kenyans, we must be a society that is willing and capable of adapting to change. So together with the former Prime Minister Raila Odinga, we came to the realization of this fact when we held talks that led to a handshake in 2018. And because of the peace that has prevailed in this country since then, many Kenyans have forgotten what was happening at the time. Fellow Kenyans, truth be told, we were on the verge of a divisiveness that would have deeply undermined our continuity, our unity, and our peace. There were those reckless few who threatened the destruction of our nation, but they actually got a hearing from sections of the public that felt only drastic action could erase their frustrations. Fellow Kenyans, we have seen how many, many nations, some that we share borders with, have trodden that path and has led to their destruction and ruin. I can tell you honestly, as your president, who consumes first-hand information from a multitude of sources, if there had been no handshake, this country would have been brought to its knees. The reckless aggressiveness of some, the triumphant chest thumping and stonewalling by others, the handshake stabilized the country, and it has afforded us the opportunity to identify the practical reforms that would strengthen our unity, inclusivity, equity, and good governance. The Building Bridges Initiative was basically a vehicle for us to have a national conversation. A conversation, fellow Kenyans, that lasted over 2 years. BBI provided an opportunity for Kenyans to say what was on their minds and to provide ideas that could be effected to solve Kenya's most intractable problems. Both the BBI Task Force and eventually the BBI Steering Committee listened to thousands of Kenyans from all walks of life in every one of our 47 counties, individual Kenyans, women groups, youth groups, persons living with disabilities, religious leaders, pastoral communities, trade unions, professional associations, county assemblies, members of parliament, various experts, a whole cross-section of Kenyans. And first, Kenyans expressed their views, which were collated and presented as what we term as the first BBI report that was released in November of 2019. Then Kenyans gave more views under BBI 2, which was meant to be a validation exercise to ascertain the views expressed in the first BBI and to establish whether these were actually the views Kenyans had shared. Unfortunately, with the onset of COVID-19, we were unable to release the report earlier, but eventually we had an opportunity not too long ago to review the contents of that second BBI. And as you know, more views emerged at this stage, and most of these views were publicly stated in various regional rallies and other fora. The validation report was then launched on October 26th, attracting many views and calls for such views to be considered. And indeed, I am happy to say that these views have been considered, and I personally have met with several different groupings and individual Kenyans, and I truly believe that all their issues have been incorporated, as the referendum bill released today shall clearly indicate. So I am therefore confident that this process has been widely consultative and has captured the best of our ideas and ideals. And this is not the end of the process, because Kenyans will continue to express themselves and eventually make a choice on the fate of this referendum bill. But Kenyans, let me and allow me to highlight some of the points and gains in the referendum bill, particularly those raised by various interest groups. On the gender parity and participation question, something that has haunted and been unattainable in this country since the dawn of independence, this bill ensures that the women of Kenya will actively be involved in all levels of representation. Women leaders will now comprise 50% of all senators. This means that they will be directly involved and be in charge of determining how 35% of our national resources are spent in the counties. Additionally, within this document, there is a new mechanism for ensuring greater and meaningful participation of our women in the National Assembly. And we are doing this while retaining the affirmative orientation in appointative posts, which, as you know, has been instrumental in placing many Kenyan women in high positions in government. The drafters of this referendum bill also listened to the plight of PWDs and youths and have ensured that they are adequately represented in Parliament. Kenyans consistently expressed their view that there was an urgent need to strengthen devolution And this referendum bill considers this point and proposes an increase of money available to counties. It also creates a ward development fund that will be a game changer by taking government money directly to the grassroots. And not only that, the bill before us also proposes a strengthened Senate that is able to oversight the counties more robustly, and it also requires county assemblies and the Senate to ensure greater accountability of the increased funds going to the counties. To ensure that every Kenyan enjoys the democracy that the 2010 Constitution so ably promised, the bill cures the problem of underrepresentation in some areas of the country and introduces a better approach for the sharing of resources more equitably and fairly while dealing with the issues of marginalization. Although the principle of public participation is already enshrined in our Constitution, participation has faced numerous challenges in the past. The BBI proposals will ensure greater public participation at all levels, from the ward to the constituency, to the county, as well as to the national government. In the spirit of public participation, embodied in the entire BBI process, where we are now, as has been indicated by the speakers before me, is that we now need to go out and collect signatures from Kenyans. This, fellow Kenyans, is in line with the tenets of democracy, whereby every single citizen is entitled to have their say. The process of staging a national referendum is the last exercise in validation of the issues articulated in the BBI report and the last stage in asking for the stamp of approval from Kenyans on the report's recommendations. This marks a mass validation of the proposed amendments as captured by the BBI steering committee. So as we embark on signature collection exercise, we recognize that the exercise of collecting signatures is a continuation of the democratic deliberation provided for in the Constitution. We once again take these proposals to you Kenyans, requesting that you confirm and endorse these proposals, and to ensure informed decision-making by Kenyans, the bill will be made available through newspapers, while the BBI report is available through electronic and print formats, and include abridged and summarized versions to ensure everybody reads this particular bill. Finally, as again has been said by the speakers before me, I say that we are embarking on this exercise the height of the COVID-19 pandemic. And we are forging ahead not because we are careless, but because we consider this process as crucial to the positive future of our republic. BBI, fellow Kenyans, is a bridge to peace. It is a bridge to prosperity that every Kenyan today and in generations to come needs desperately. Let us make it clear during this process of collecting of signatures that all public health guidelines will be adhered to by all Kenyans, by all leaders, irrespective of anyone's social status, because even as we proceed, we must never forget that we are personally responsible for the well-being and health of each and every one of us. Kenyans are asking for these changes so that you can enjoy them, but you cannot enjoy them if you are dead from an avoidable and preventable disease. Therefore, walk into the town hall with confidence, because it is your civic duty to be a responsible citizen, but take all the necessary precautions. It is indeed my hope that Kenyans will overwhelmingly support this amendment bill and secure their futures and our future as a united country. Wenzangu, safari hii tulianza mbali. Na ningependa kuomba sana ya kwamba tusiwe watu ambao wanasahau haraka haraka alafu wanaenda kurudia makosa ambayo wameifanya. Wakenya wenzangu, hii bill ambayo iko mbele yetu mwanzo wake ulikuwa kwa shida ambazo tulizipata baada ya uchaguzi wa mwaka what 2017, na tukaona ya kwamba hii ni shida ambaye kila wakati ambapo tuko na uchaguzi, badala ya kutoka kwa huo uchaguzi wa Kenya wakiwa pamoja, mara nyingi tuamaliza uchaguzi wa Kenya wakiwa wamegawanyika. Na mambo haya yametendeka katika taifa letu kurudi nyuma miaka mingi zaidi ya 20-25. Kuwa wengine wanajisikia ndio wenye serikali na wengine wanajiona ya kwamba wametengwa na serikali. Na mambo haya ndio inalete vurugu katika taifa letu. Na ndipo tulionelea mwaka wa 2017 mwisho na kuanza mwaka wa 2018 kwa kuona yale ambayo alikuwa yanatendeka katika sehemu mbalimbali, Wakenya wakipigana na Wakenya wenzao, tukaamua pamoja na Mheshimiwa Raila ya kwamba yastahili kama viongozi tusikae tu na tuone damu ya Wakenya ikimwagika kwa sababu yetu sisi, kwa sababu ya siasa. Na nchi ilikuwa karibu kugawanyika nusu. Na mimi nilikuwa mstari wa mbele kuchapa hawa watu wa NASA, na nilifanya nikajaribu nikapata hapo 50 plus, huyo alikataa. Kaenda kotini akanilazimisha kurudia. Nikarudia akatoroka. Na akaambia watu wake wasipige kura. Basi sisi tukaendelea. Lakini ukweli wa mambo ni ya kwamba taifa letu tulikuwa tumegawanyika katikati. Kuna sehemu wengine hawangeweza kupita ati kwa sababu wewe ni wa chama hii, wewe ni wa chama ile. Na wakati tulikuja pamoja tukasema, this is not possible, this is not right. Hatutafuti uongozi ndio wa Kenya wapigane, tuatafuta uongozi ndio tutafute utajiri wa taifa letu na wa Kenya wetu waweze kuishi na amani na furaha na kwa umoja. Na hiyo ndio ilikuwa msingi wa ile kitu ambacho tunaita handshake leo. Na ndipo nimesema kwa hii ambaye nimesoma kwa lugha ya kimombo hapa, ambapo nimesema ya kwamba tunasahau haraka sana kwa sababu ya ile amani ambaye tumekuwa naye miaka hii miwili. watu wanaona hiyo ni kama kawaida tu, lakini sio kawaida. Na ndipo tukaamua lazima turekebishe haya. Na kwangu mimi hiyo haikuwa mara yangu ya kwanza ku reach out. Nime reach out hata mbeleni, hata mwenzangu Deputy William Ruto, mimi we reached out tukalete amani, na ikakuwa na amani. Sasa ubaya uko wapi, wa Kenya wenzangu? Nikireach out pia kwa ndugu yangu ndio tuweze kuongeza hiyo amani. Na ndipo nasema ya kwamba wale ambao wanajaribu kuchimbua makaburi, nilisoma kwa gazeti juzi, wasifikiri wanacheza. Mimi siwezi kukubaliana na mambo kama haya. Tumetoka huko na mambo haya, tumezika katika kaburi ya sahau. Kwa sababu ukijaribu kulete maneno hapa, wewe hujui ni shida gani. Anayo wengine hawafikiri. You don't think before you talk, you don't think before you act. You must always think before you do something. Sisi hatutaki vita katika taifa letu la Kenya. Sisi wengine wetu tunajua maana ya amani. Na sisi tunataka kurekebisha zile shida, na turekebishe kwa njia ya kikatiba, kwa njia ya kisheria, ndio Kenya isonge mbele na Wakenya wawe kitu kimoja. Hiyo ndio haja yetu kubwa. Sio kuja hapa kila siku kuambiwa hii na hii na hii. Let us be faithful to the peace, to the stability, to the unity of this nation. Na kuna mengi ambayo labda wengine wangependa wangependa iwe ndani ya hii amendment. Lakini Wakenya wenzangu, ni wakumbushe, Kenya sio kama maisha ya binadamu. Sisi tukiwa binadamu, viumbe vya Mwenyezi Mungu, tunajua ya kwamba muda wetu huanza kuhesabiwa kutoka siku ile tulizaliwa. Na tunajua bado huo muda utafika. Kenya itaishi milele na milele na milele. And that is why we do some of the things that we do. Not for what we gain today, but what shall be there for our children and our children and our children's children in the future, because Kenya will be here forever. And our responsibility is to be architects of that future. That is our responsibility. And tomorrow, there will be those Kenyans who will be in positions of leadership. Ambao watasema, unajua sasa tumekubaliana kitu ingine. Na watafanya amendment ingine. Na wengine watakuja, watafanya amendment ingine. Na ndipo tunasema katiba yuhai. Katiba sio vile tumeona nchi zingine, unasema kwa sababu imeandikwa kwa katiba, right? Hiyo ni kumaliza nchi. Unaona watu wanasema, unaona vile katiba inasema, kwa hivyo wewe nyamaza. Sasa kunyamaza na mtu anasema mimi niko na kitu ambayo inaniuma, na wewe unaniambia ni nyamaze ati kwa sababu imeandikwa. My friend, is that not a recipe for war? Right? That is a recipe for war. And we have seen it in other countries. Mwingine ana brandish katiba ambaye ilichorwa miaka 100 iliyopita. Angalia, angalia, angalia katiba. We nyamaza. Na ukiongea utaniona. Haya, na yeye atasema basi nitaongea. Na ukinikaribia wewe ndio utaona. That is the beginning of war. And that is why we say this document is alive. This document is supposed to treat the problems and the challenges that face us as a nation. Let us not take it as a divisive document. Let us not take it as a document that is going to contain all our issues. Because at different stages in a nation's history, in a nation's life, there will come others And you will see Second Amendment, Third Amendment. I think in America, after 200 years now, they are on Amendment namna gani, ndugu yangu? Huh? 37 amendments. All right? It will be the same with ours. It will be the same with ours, my friends. Right? What we are doing is just starting. And just starting with that is most critical. Dealing with the issues that make us consistently fight. The issues of inclusion and inclusivity. Dealing with the issues of ensuring equitable resources. Dealing with the issues of ensuring that money reaches the lowest level possible. Dealing with the issues of corruption and governance. These are the things that make people fight. These are the issues that we are dealing with at this stage. Fellow Kenyans, let's come together. Sort that out. Other chapters will be sorted out. Nikimalizia. Kuna kipengele moja peke yake ambaye nimesema hapa ya kwamba nimesikiza wengi kutoka wajumbe, maseneta, viongozi, mbali mbali. Mimi siendi kwa magazeti, mimi nakutana na watu tu. Wewe sasa mimi sema. Niambie kwa sababu mimi sio mtu ya hiyo, hata Twitter mnaona na hiyo. Mimi niliondoka huko. Ngaona hii kitu ni bure, ni matusi tu. Hakuna kitu kingine inaendelea hapa. Right? Unakaa hapo unasoma hulali. Nini wanasema nini? Huyu sasa wewe unapiga simu. Unaona vile huyu mtu amenituka. Afadhali nilale bana. Niongee. Nipige story hapo na mama kidogo hapo. Nilale, niamke, niende kazi, dunia iendelee. Kama ni namna gani jamani? Lakini kwa wale wengi ambao nimeweza kupata nafasi ya kukutana nao na kudebate nao one on one. There was one group I met with ambao walisema kitu na mimi nikaona kwa kweli. Hata kama katiba ya sasa imetuhakikishia hiyo, nikaona ni vizuri vile waliniambia turudie tena. Na hawa ni wenzetu viongozi wa kidini wakati nilikaa na wao. Wakasema tunajua iko hapo, lakini hii document lazima isisitize tena umuhimu wa kumcha Mwenyezi Mungu na umuhimu na centrality ya Mungu katika taifa letu la Kenya. Na nataka niwashukuru kwa sababu nimeona wameongeza hapa kusema, in embarking on this constitutional amendment process, the people of Kenya reaffirm their conviction in the words of the preamble of our constitution, asserting the supremacy of the Almighty God in shaping the destiny of the nation. Na ndipo tuasema, Mungu ailinde taifa letu la Kenya. Mungu alinde vizazi vilivyo na vijavyo. Mungu atusaidie tuwe na amani, tuwe na umoja, tuwe na upendo kati yetu. Mungu asaidie taifa la Kenya iwe taifa ambalo litamiliki wananchi wake na prosperity ambaye itakuwa ya kushangaza hata dunia ambazo zimeendelea. Mungu atusaidie tuweze tuelewane, tuongee pamoja, tufanye yale ambayo yako mbele yetu kwa amani na kwa kujuliana hali, tukijua ya kwamba Kenya sio ya mtu. Kenya haina mwenyewe, ina wenyewe. na wenyewe ni wale vile nimesema wako na wale ambao watakuwa. Mungu awabariki, Mungu awalinde, asanteni sana.